Next parasite that we are going to discuss in parasitology series is Ankylostoma duodenale. Common name is hookworm. Habitat, it has one host, that is human being. In humans, it lives in the intestine, mostly in the jejunum part. It is pink or white in fresh feces due to ingested blood. Pink color is due to ingested blood. Some of its life cycle part, it develops inside the soil. In the soil, the infective stage is filary form larva. Inside human being, it has worms, adult worm, morphologically we can see, and eggs are also seen. Coming to morphology, this is a hookworm having a female worm. The anterior part, it looks like a hook to be fastened anywhere, and a tapering posterior end. Anterior end in like a hook and posterior tapering end. It is having the buccal mucosa, again denticulated buccal mucosa, having a dorsal lip and two pairs of ventricle lip like this. It is having a bulb like esophagus, and female having the uterus, double bulb uterus like this. This is the Ankylostoma female worm having double bulb uterus, having an esophagus present in both male and the female. Okay, this is female worm. These are the coiled ovaries, we can call that is in a tube form, coiled tube like ovaries. There are two ovaries that are coiled together. The size is 10 to 13 mm. Okay. The male worm is smaller than the female, and the posterior end of the male expands in a fan-like structure known as cervical alley. These are the two pairs of ventral, one pair of dorsal lip, the esophagus and the testicular cloacal opening, and this is the cervical alley that helps to grab the female during mating. This is copulatory bursa. These are the copulatory. These are the copulatory spicules. These are the opening cloaca and the anal opening. The male measures 8 to 11 mm. If you see the anterior structure of both male and female, it is like this, having a dorsal lip and two ventral lips. Whenever mating takes place, this is a female parasite, and the male parasite and the female parasite, they look like a Y-shaped structure, like this. This is Y-shaped mating structure whenever the male and the female are mating. Once the female gets fertilized, it becomes gravid, that is full of egg. The egg of ankylostoma has a thick outer layer known as hyaline membrane. And inside is present four blastomeres, each having a nucleus. This is egg of ankylostoma duodenal. This is hyaline membrane. These are the four blastomeres. So this kind of structure is seen in the feces. Okay. Now the life cycle starts. When the female gets fertilized, it produces egg. This egg is shed down with the feces. It reaches soil. The characteristic of the soil is it prefers loamy soil that is moist and in shady atmosphere. It remains there for 2 days and then it converts into rhabditiform larva. This is the thick hyaline sheath and this is the larva. This is rhabditiform larva. This rhabditiform larva is about 250 μm, and this rhabditiform larva is present in the soil. In the soil, it increases its size by feeding on bacteria and organic matter. It feeds on bacteria and organic matter and it increases its size, and then it undergoes molting. First molting on third day. It took 2 days to convert into a rhabditiform larva. Third day, first molting, and fifth day, second molting. After molting, it comes out of this eggshell and becomes a larva like this. This larva is known as phyllariform larva. This phyllariform larva can live for 5 weeks in soil, ready to enter inside the host. It enters inside the host when the host walks barefoot. Nange paav agar aise soil ke upar host walk karte hain, since it is having this hook like structure, it can penetrate. Or if the person or the host. It walks on the and bare palms रख करके या buttocks, bare buttocks, naked buttocks के साथ ऐसे soil के ऊपर अगर बैठते हैं, नंगे पैर चलते हैं, palms अपने हाथों को रख देते हैं soil के ऊपर, या फिर अपने buttocks, naked buttocks के साथ ऐसे soil के ऊपर बैठते हैं, then this phalariform larva enters the host through penetration. It penetrates the skin of the toes, foot, sole and hands. यहाँ के skin को ये penetrate कर सकते हैं. Penetrate करके it reaches subcutaneous tissues. From subcutaneous tissues, it enters circulation. From circulation, it enters right heart. Right heart से ये पहुंच जाता है lungs में. Lungs alveoli को penetrate करता है. It reaches respiratory tract. From respiratory tract, it reaches epiglottis. From epiglottis, it reaches pharynx. Pharynx में जाकर के it is swallowed. It reaches jejunum, part of the intestine, where it undergoes third molting. In jejunum, it attaches itself with the help of buccal capsule having one dorsal and two pair of lips. Iske help se it attaches to the intestinal wall. There it undergoes fourth molting. Within 6 weeks and after fourth molting, it becomes adult and it may either convert into a male worm or a female worm. One egg will convert into one worm. Once the female gets fertilized, it may produce up to 25,000 of eggs per day. 25,000 eggs per day. Okay, this is life cycle of ankylostoma, hook like worm present in the intestine. Hook, it is having two ventral hooks and one dorsal. These are ventral hooks, these are dorsal hook. This portion is bent, giving it a hook like structure. The female gets fertilized, produces 25,000 eggs per day. The egg is having a thick hyaline membrane, 4 blastomeres. This is passed on with the feces, comes to the soil, develops into labritiform larva within 2 days. From labritiform form larva, this larva feeds on bacteria, organic matter, undergoes 2 molting in the soil itself, converts into phalariform larva. This phalariform larva is the infective stage. This phalariform larva has the capacity to penetrate. This is the infective stage, phalariform larva. It penetrates the skin. It can penetrate the skin of hand, sole, toes and foot. Enters subcutaneous, reaches circulation, reaches right heart, lungs, alveoli, respiratory. These all path it travels and reaches to the jejunum. Swallowed by esophagus, reaches jejunum, third molting, attaches to the intestinal mucosal wall by its denticulated lips, undergoes fourth molting, becomes adult and again matures as a sexually male and female worm. Now about the pathogenesis. Pathogenesis pathogenesis of ankylostoma duodenal. Whenever it enters, चाहे वो पैर के यहाँ से एंटर करे या वो पाम से एंटर करेगा, जहाँ पे से भी वो एंटर करता है, इट कॉजेज लोकल इचिंग, इट कॉजेज एरिडर्मेटस रैश, इट कॉजेज स्क्रैचिंग, जहाँ एंटर करेगा वहाँ पे खुजली होने लगती है तो स्क्रैचिंग हो जाते हैं. दिस ऑल्सो अकाउंट्स फॉर सेकेंडरी बैक्टीरियल इन्फेक्शन. इट ऑल्सो कॉजेज ग्राउंड इच. इट ऑल्सो कॉजेज क्रीपिंग इरप्शन. जैसे जैसे फाइलेरीफॉर्म लार्वा ट्रैवल करता है फ्रॉम हार्ट टू लंग्स एंड एल्वियोली एंड देन इसोफेगस अगेन स्वैलोड, जहाँ जहाँ वो क्रीप करता है, ट्रैवल करता है, देयर इट कॉजेज क्रीपिंग इरप्शन. एंड ड्यू टू इट्स बक्कल म्यूकोसा इट मे कॉज लीकल लोकल हीमरेज. This patient harboring these kind of worms also show clinical pneumonia. This parasite feeds on intestinal tissues, epithelial cells, and blood also. It may take about 2 ml of blood per day. Since it feeds on blood, the host shows microcytic hypochromic iron deficiency anemia. Okay, this is the pathogenesis of ankylostoma. That this is all about ankylostoma. Thank you. Yes, continuing the pathogenesis of ankylostoma, if the load for pathogenesis, okay, if the load is below 100, then the patient shows no symptoms load of worm. If the load of worm is below 100, patient shows no symptoms. If the load of the worm is above 500 up to 1000, then there is heavy blood loss and the patient may suffer from anemia. And if we see the feces, in the feces, if there are 5 eggs per mg of feces, then there is no infection. If 20 eggs per mg is seen, then clinical disease, patient may show clinical symptoms. If 50 eggs per mg, then it is massive infection. It also shows intestinal syndrome by presence of a peptic ulcer is seen, epigastric pain is seen, dyspepsia is seen, and the patient also suffers from vomiting. Diarrhea, in the diarrhea, stool becomes red or black in color, red because of the presence of RBC. Pulmonary syndrome is also seen, that is known as Law-Effler's syndrome. During its travel, it may cause some disturbance in the pulmonary part also. The patient becomes dull, the working capacity is reduced, and the learning capacity is also reduced. The patient is disturbed. Hemoglobin falls because it feeds on blood. Sallow appearance of skin, rough or dry ho jati hai, and conjunctiva and tongue also becomes dry. Hypoproteinemia is seen because of loss of RBC, edema and effusion in serous cavities is also seen. In severe condition, cardiac failure may also occur. Some more symptoms that the patient shows is dyspnea, palpitation, dizziness, puffy, edema. Lab diagnosis, eggs we can see having the four blastomeres. This is the characteristic feature that may be seen. And for treatment, albendazole and mebendazole is the drug of choice.